We've waited for this day. We're gathered in your name, calling out to you. Your glory like a fire, awakening desire, will burn our hearts with truth. You're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of my praise. In this place, your glory on our face, we're looking to the sky. Descending like a cloud, you're standing with us now, Lord. You're the reason we're singing. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord. Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord. Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory. We want to see you, we want to see you. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise.
Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Just one word, you heal what's broken inside me.
just one touch, I feel the power of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see, my heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that a God can't do, there's not a mountain that He can move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way, there's nothing that our God can't do. There's nothing that our God can't do, there's not a prison wall He can't break through. Oh, praise the name that makes a way, there's nothing that our God can't do. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus.
I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus.
I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like His power. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a prison wall He can't break through. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Thousand generations falling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the Lamb. And all who've gone before us and all who will believe will sing the song of ages to the Lamb.
Your name is the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all thrones and dominions, all power and positions, your name stands above them all, and the angels cry, oh, creation cries, holy, you are lifted high, holy, holy forever. If you've been forgiven, and if you've been redeemed, sing the song forever. If you walk in freedom, and if you bear His name, sing the song forever to the Lamb. sing the song forever and amen. And the angels cry, holy, all creation cries, holy, you are lifted high, holy, holy forever. Hear your people sing, holy to the King of Kings, holy you will always be, holy, holy forever. Your name is the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all thrones and dominions, all power and positions, your name stands above them all, and the angels cry, holy, all creation.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. All the goodness of God, I will sing of the goodness of God.
May God be gracious to us. May God bless us. May he make his face to shine upon us. Oh, let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all of the peoples praise you. Good morning. It is good to be together, God's people, and thanks to the team for leading us and preparing our hearts already. Just, oh, you could sense the Spirit of the living God. Praise be to him. It's kind of a unique day or a unique year, and I'm thinking that this works. The spirit that we had yesterday as we did George Vieter's funeral, just a spirit of worship, I think that song, Goodness of God, just kind of describes what he would say. How it is that the Spirit of the living Lord and the goodness of God just came after him, and it's a joy. But here's what I want you to do today. Today, the whole world is the same age. It only happens once every 1,000 years. I'm going, that excites me. I'm one of that, you know, in that 1,000. Your age and your year of birth. So last night while I was typing this up, I said, I'm going to test it on George. So you take 97 years. He was born in 1926. And it adds up to 2023. So here's what I'm going to ask you to do, just in your mind. Take your age, take the year you were born, add it together, and if it doesn't equal 2023, I want you to stand up. The whole team's got it wrong up here, that's for sure. Is it true? Is it working? I don't know who invented this or thought of it. I mean, can you imagine? What kind of people just sit around all day thinking, I wonder what I could do for the next 1,000 years or whatever it is, right? It does astound me that there's something to it, but then I think of all of the wonders and the goodness of God. I want to reflect on those things with you today and just say, wow, I want you to come and see. I want you to come and listen. I want you to come and praise the King of Kings. So that's a joy and it's a privilege. So this morning, I say grace and peace to you as it comes to you in the abundance through the knowledge of God and of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. If you would, pray these next slides with me as we open up together. Oh, let the name of the Lord be praised. Heavenly Father, I choose to bless you and give you thanks. You alone are worthy of my praise. You alone are faithful and just. I am so privileged to be known by you and loved by you and to love you in return. In the company of these fellow worshipers, I give you glorious praise. Spirit of God, aid me now to worship the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. So if you would stand and greet one another, and maybe you can share what ride you went on. Like Glenn Muller probably went on the zipper. Let's find out who else did that, all right? Greet one another.
All right. So this morning I started with some of the verses from Psalm 67. I'm asking you now to help as we prepare to sing together in Psalm 66. So if you would, again, read this piece with me. Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of His name. Give to Him glorious praise. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies come cringing to you. All the earth worships you and sings praises to you. They sing praises to your name. So this morning, just think of this awesome truth, right? We had a dog named King, and every time he got into the garbage and my dad would call him on it and he'd say, King, get over here. He put his tail between his legs, and he knew he was going to get a little touch on his snout, and it's like he comes cringing. That's the enemies of God. That's not us. Ha-ha! What do we get to do? We get to come with joy, with confidence, and full of the Spirit to say, God, joyfully do we adore you. Let's continue to worship.
Joyful, joyful, we adore you, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before you, hold me to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. All thy works rejoice around thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays. Stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and glowing fountain, call us to rejoice in thee. Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed, wellspring of the joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Thou art Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love are thine. Teach us how to love each other, lift us to the joy divine. Mortals, join the mighty chorus, wish the morning stars begin. Father's love is reigning o'er us, brother love binds man to man. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music lifts us onward, in the triumph song of life.
A thousand generations
falling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the Lamb. And all who've gone before us and all who will believe will sing the song of ages to the Lamb.
Your name is the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, your name stands above them all, and the angels cry, "Holy." Song forever to the Lamb. If you walk in freedom, and if you bear His name, sing the song forever to the Lamb. We'll sing the song forever and amen, and the angels cry, "Oh."
So God, that's why we want to worship you. You are unchanging. You are always good. You are always kind. You are holy. You are without sin. And because of that, and Jesus Christ being fully God, we recognize that our sins are removed from us as far as the east is from the west. And we declare your goodness. We join all creation. So thank you that we can declare the goodness of God this morning as God's people. We bless you, and we thank you for allowing us the privilege to worship. In Christ's name, amen. And be seated. Amen.
After thinking about this, all the events of this last week and 2 weeks even, and thank you for allowing Kathy and I the privilege of heading over to Colorado. There were 225 pastors and elders gathered together from the various Alliance churches. We had people from the East Coast in New York, all the way to the West Coast down in Los Angeles, and most of us were from the Midwest, so that was a good thing, but the Spirit is evident, and we're grateful to God for allowing new wind to come into the sails of the Alliance of Reformed Churches. So to Him, indeed, be all the glory. That's it. All right, so if you're young, let's see, Miss Kathy, I'm going to push you just a little bit that way. If you're young, I want you to sit in these two rows. These two rows. So the front one is good. There you go. Lock. Yep, front two rows. Where do you think? Locking. Right there, you're going to start it? Be good. All right, so as the kids are coming in and up, keep going. All right. So just a reminder, next week is the fourth week of the month. There you go. Oh, right. Oh, you want to sit there? Go ahead. A lot of people don't listen to the pastor, so that's fine. Like herds. Oh, I'm so glad. Look at that. All right, we're going to have to make a little room right here. Finley, take Nona, put her in there. Woo, yeah. Joella, Johanna, good morning, everybody. Oh, what else can we say? Where do you want to sit? You want to sit right in there? Can you move? Is that a good job? You want to start in the third row? Go ahead. Jameson, hey, be a trendsetter, dude. Yep. Oh, you guys scooch over just a little bit. Let the Weirsma girls in. Yay. Wow. So, again, thanks for coming alongside. Financial support, we can't do anything without it. And you'll hear some of that about the beef booth, too. In fact, right now, I'm saying, Mr. Terry Wildreyer, if you would come up. And as he does that, I'm going to give a quick word to you. So when he's done, when he's all done, we're going to clap, all right?
Got to get my notes out.
Can you write it a little bigger?
I'm not that. I can see it. We're going to give you a recap on the week we've had. I think you're going to be surprised. We made about 6,500 sandwiches over the 4 days. We sold 4,320 ears of corn. And I don't know how many beans.
Let's see, you add up the number of beans from this day and you add them up with a year and then it comes to 2023.
155 gallons of beans and 2,400 pounds of meat.
Wow.
So it was a kind of a busy week and I felt it on Friday. But anyway, I just wanted to give you a little recap and we broke a record. We made over or took in over $72,000. So.
Jameson, question.
Yep, we saw that.
In fact, you spoiled it for me, but we're going to show a picture in a minute.
Anyway, Wednesday it was hot in the booth, so I went out walking around. I can't stand that long, so I just go walking. And I went through the eating place, and anybody that had a tri-tip sandwich in the corn and that, I went and asked them, you know, how they liked it, you know, that kind of stuff. And this one lady, she said to me, she says, I thought we had plenty of signage, what we were, CRC stood for and stuff. And she says, what does CRC stand for? And I said, Chancellor Reformed Church. And she says, my hat goes off to you guys. You smile, you look like you're having fun, and you're very polite. Amy would say thank you at the till, and the people that were handing out the sandwich, they'd say enjoy it, you know, and have a great day or whatever. So really, you guys need an applause too. So. And my last thing is I want to thank everybody that helped with it and my committee. I wouldn't be able to do this without you guys. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. So here's what we're going to do. School is going to start pretty soon. Some people are going to be cheerleaders and for sports and stuff. So I want you to stand up, turn around, and then just look at everybody, and we're going to clap. Ready? So stand up, turn around, and clap for them. Say, yay! Good job. All right, so now you can be seated, and we're going to do that again in just a minute, all right? So here's that infamous car. You saw that car? Man, can you believe it? Like, doesn't he care? You'd think he'd wash it or polish it or something. It's just, oh, it hurt my heart to see it. But then I was really, really glad. He paid, of the $72,000 gross that I think we got, I think he paid a $10,000 sponsorship. It was amazing. Look at that. Wow. Oh, thank you to his dear wife for sponsoring that car, too. That was pretty cool. But anyway, nice advertisement. And, of course, pictures are thousands of words. Here's young and old. That's the joy. If you're watching on Facebook or later on YouTube, we love being an intergenerational church. We'll take you at any age. But the joy that's ours in working together. Pictures tell it all. So we even let young kids and, well, Risa, what were you trying to do? I got to think, you're putting butter in Sita's ear or something, I figure. That was kind of a cool thing. But, yeah, just the joy. I didn't get any pictures of Cornhuskers. I'm sorry about that. But there's the beef booth. And, yeah, we've done well. So here's the next part. We're going to read this together, and then I'm going to have you do our thing again. Ready? So can you read that? Yeah, we can read that together. Ready? Dear God, thank you for the amazing teachers who have given their lives to serve our children. As they prepare for the new year, fill them with strength to lead, grace to guide, and hope to thrive in their classroom. Bless them beyond measure for their willingness to pour into the next generation through education. Amen. All right, so now we're going to have the teachers. If you're a teacher, public school, private school, you've already started, or you're a substitute teacher, we want you to stand. All of us, stand up. Teacher, stand. Ready? Turn around, and clap. Booyah! All right, teacher, stay standing. And now if you're a student, if you're going to start school, or you started this last week, but I think we start on Wednesday, park, whatever. So if you're a student, stand up as well. We got a few more? No. Oh, yeah. Haley, are you going to school? Come on, you can't be a truant. Oh, good. All right, here we go. We're going to pray for them, and then we're going to clap. Ready? God, we give you thanks again for teachers, but we give you thanks for students, for those that are willing to use the brains that you've given to them, their creative ability. Let it be that they would shine. Let it be that they would shine for the Lord Jesus Christ on their playgrounds, in their hallways, in the discussions that they have with fellow students. So we commend them to your care, and we ask that you would just bless them over the course of this year. Help them to be godly and upright and filled with joy for the gift of learning, in Jesus' name. Amen. Ready? Clap. And you may be seated. Everybody may be seated now. Everybody may be seated now. Sometimes I think I'm at home. Oh. Let's clap. Let's clap. Oh, Lord, forgive us all. So guess what? At our church, we say everybody's a star. We just love everybody. So here's what I'm going to ask you to do.
There's a star on it?
There's a star on it. And that's what you are. God loves you that way. So if you would take one, please, and go back and sit with grandpa or grandma or whoever. They're all the same, just a different color package. These are fruit roll-up things, right? Now you can go sit with your parents or grandparents. There you go.
Hello.
And you know what? Take one for your dad, just because he did such a nice job. Second place on that car. All right. Go ahead. Take one. They're all the same. They're just different package colors. How's that? Your birthday party today. Dude, I didn't get the invitation in the mail. Oh. And you clapped?
Yeah.
Awesome.
And my stepdad, Ben, is a substitute teacher.
A substitute teacher, too? Wow.
Yeah.
Good job.
I kept saying Ben.
That's a joy. Thank you, everybody. Wow. Oh. Hey, Mr. Ethan. Ah, yes. So, oh, you're welcome. In 2 weeks, I got to think, no, 3 Sundays from now, it's going to be the kickoff carnival, and you're going to hear more about it over the coffee hour, but I want you to make sure that you know we're going to have, like, popcorn, we're going to have games, we're going to have a clown. It's just going to be cool. Maybe cotton candy? Should we put that order in? All right. If you're here and you're able to help, we want a cotton candy maker, maybe. Maybe. We'll see. No promises. Woo. You have one. Oh! Let's clap. Yeah, Miss Vanessa! We need $1,000. Nobody put their hand up, I know. All right, folks, here we go as we get ready to pray one for each other, right? So Larry Hogestrati's got a 75th birthday coming this Thursday. He's having a tough week this past week, I will say that. And so can we maybe shower him with cards? Let's take an extra step and send those. If you need an address, I'll put the address in the email that goes out this afternoon. So we'll do that. So for Larry, Dennis and Mary Kay are in Okoboji right now, doing a little rest, relaxation, but they are moving into the house across the street. And it's being gutted, and we're just grateful for how it is that the sons and the in-laws and the rest are all doing that work and taking care of them. Brian and Belinda were here yesterday for the funeral as well, and they're taking a trip to the East Coast to do itinerary, so speaking at the churches that have supported them, and we want to bless them. Kim Clock's sister, Jennifer, back at Avera Hospital here, a blockage, something intestinal or stomach. And so we want to continue to pray. Donna Plucker was in the hospital, got out of the hospital, and yesterday went back in. She's having difficulties controlling her sugar count, severely diabetic. And so letting you know, we'll pray for her. Daryl, we continue to lift up in prayer. Kathy Stever, it just hasn't, what I call that, closed 100%. And so there's she's spending more time in the bed than in the chair. So. And George, yeah, the flowers in the lobby are a gift, and I just need to say to you, Terry said what a great congregation you are, but Jill and Holly were just absolutely floored at how it is that you came alongside and supported this past week, from doing things in people's lawns to serving out of the kitchen. I love the church, and that's a good thing. So, and new families, we've got 3 that are coming in just a moment, and then there are people who are just saying, I want to know more about this Jesus. I had a lady yesterday ask some questions, and so I'm just, let's keep praying that God increases the family, right? You've come with some things. I think it's important just to create a little space. We're going to have some silence, and if kids act out, that's what they do. But we're just going to spend a little time in silence. Think about the song that we just ended with, right? Holy Forever. The angels are singing, and you and I get to sing, and we get to worship. So I invite you just to spend a moment, and then I'll lead us in prayer. Lord, as we read this past week in our Words of Hope devotionals, there's something about silence. Silence does the heavy lifting. It lifts things off of us and it allows us just to focus, to create that space for you to speak, for us to hear, for us to declare in a one-on-one sort of relationship. how awesome and how holy and how good you are. Lord, we give you thanks for the good news of a beef booth. We thank you that all of the work and the joy and the labors were all so worth it. It's like every Turner County Fair, we get to celebrate this harvest that goes to help missions, be it an orphanage in Guatemala, be it an individual church's mission, be it missionaries, be it kids at a Christian camp. There is just so much that is done. And the joy of giving and passing it on, wow. And so between that and the White Cross and Operation Christmas Child and doing a carnival kickoff, so much of that stuff, God, yes, it's labor intensive, but it is such a joy to reach out to others as well as to encourage each of us in the faith. And so we're asking for encouragement, even now this morning, that your hand would be upon Donna, on Dennis, Jennifer Langle, Larry Hogestrat. I think of Jill Foster and Holly Hofer and George's extended family. Think of Ken Levalier, Kathy Stever. Think of those that are needing to make decisions about where to live. As age continues to creep up on each of us, we give you thanks that we live in a country where there is freedom to worship. We give you thanks that we get to live in a country where boys and girls get to go to school. Thank you for teachers. Lord, we ask for a special measure of strength and wisdom for teachers, especially as parenting has taken a whole different turn in the last 20 years. As kids and attitudes and stuff have changed, allow teachers to be flexible and loving and to be a solid anchor for these kids in terms of the routines even. We give you thanks that Dale Baltina had his heart checked out, and we continue to lift him up. I think of folks that this morning are just tired. Perhaps something at work, perhaps a loss of a job, or a change in an occupation. Whew. It's just good to come here, Lord, to say thanks. And maybe we don't even have a list of things. It's just good to sit in the presence of the one who loves us. So we want to say thank you. Continue to bless us, we pray. Not that we demand it, but because we're your children, we're just asking for the Spirit of the living God to be very real on each of us. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen. On a personal note, just quickly, so Kathy and I, we leave this Thursday, flying into Buffalo Thursday evening. We'll be with Kathy's father, who, again, very aged, and want to be honorable to him. We get to help at a wedding reception, and then I'll preach at my home church where I was baptized as a one-year-old or two-year-old, I guess. So we'll be back on Monday, just alerting you to that too. And then thanks for asking, but I've been in quite a bit of pain yesterday, and God was so gracious, got us through the funeral. I got home from the graveside, took off my jacket, and I couldn't move. And so they ended up taking me to acute care last night. I got a good hypo shot, and I'm on steroids. So anyway, a week Tuesday is the meeting with the surgeon, so I'm hoping that they set this date up quickly. So, swan song is over. We're praying and we're worshiping and we're choosing to rejoice. God is good. All right, take out your Bibles quickly if you would, because we're going to lead into our new members joining. So just take a quick look at Psalm 66. As you turn to it, let me just say, Psalm 66, the first half of it, about up to verse 13 or so, is about we. It's the whole congregation. And then the voice moves into an I. I want to tell you something. And so as these three families come in just a moment, they've got something to share with you. And I'm so delighted that they're doing that. So if you look at verse 1, all I can say to you here, we've opened up with those verses. But you can kind of think of come and praise, right? Shout to God for joy. So you see, come and praise. And then you move over to verse 5, and it says, come and see. Come and see what God has done. And we celebrated that. Terry was up in front here telling us, let me see what God has done. I can't believe it. We've been safe. We've been kept well. We had pork producers. We had beef boothers. We had folks on rides. And it was just good to buy a homemade ice cream and to sit down in a seat and talk to people. Wow. We got to do ministry. Kathy and I, as we sat at a table and a lady came up to us, we had known her, but she shared that her husband was in the VA hospital again, and so just able to have a conversation and to encourage. People can say that, right? Come and praise, and then verse 5, it says, come and see. And then by the time you get verse 13, I will indeed come into your house. I'm going to offer a sacrifice of praise. So the invitation from the psalmist here, for us at least, as we gather it, is come and offer. We bring the sacrifice of praise to the house of the Lord. That's why we sing, joyful, joyful, we adore you, right? Why we recognize that He is the Holy One and He is worthy of our worship. Do you bring worship every day? And then we move to our last little piece, and it's verse 16. Come and hear, all you who fear God, and I will tell. That's what you're going to hear. That's what we're going to celebrate right now as people share. Let me tell you what God's done, what He's doing, and then we'll pray over them. We'll have our song, our closing song, and we'll go. So, here we are getting ready. Church membership, is it important? All we're doing is saying, we'll have to pick a team. If I pick the Packers, Lloyd Hogestrat's happy. If I pick the Kansas City Chiefs, the whole Schroeder family is ecstatic. So what do? Let's pick the Green Bay Chiefs. Membership is just saying, I'm part of the team. I'm putting on the sweater, so to speak. You can pass the ball to me. I'm dependable. I have a position to play. The Holy Spirit has gifted me, and I want to run with the ball, or I want to catch the ball, or I want to block, whatever it might be. And so the joy of doing this is multiple levels, but we're just grateful for that. To belonging to a church is just vital. It's vital for you. It's vital for us. And we recognize again, right, while Jesus is coming back, and when He does, He comes for you, you, and you. But Scripture is always clear. He's always coming back for the bride, the church. That's us collective, right? So with that, I'm going to ask the Brett and Rachel Haynes family, come on up. Can we do that?
Yes.
Yes. Woo-hoo! I'm going to start with the kids while Mom kind of makes her way up here. She's doing so well with that healing. But Ethan and Jackson, stand right here on this step. We're going to get down. And let's do it this way. You guys stand right there. All right, here we go. Perfect. All right, what's your name?
Jackson.
And how old are you?
8 3/4.
8 3/4. Ooh, so when is your birthday?
September 24th.
Tell people to note that. Say September 24th.
September 24th.
Good, good. What sport do you like?
Soccer and football.
Soccer and football. What grade will you be in?
Third.
Third grade, good. And if there's one thing you just love doing, like is it painting or is it running? What's one thing you just love to do?
Gaming.
Gaming. Oh, nice. And who are you?
Ethan.
Ethan. How old is Ethan?
5.
5. Wow. And are you going to go to school?
Yes.
Where? Do you know what
school? Kindergarten.
Kindergarten. Oh, good job. Do you know the name of your teacher already?
I don't know.
I don't know either yet. Okay. What do you love to do? If you could play outside or run or catch chickens, what do you like to do?
Play video games and catch kitties.
Oh, catch kitties. Oh.
Babies.
Oh, babies. Oh, good job, good job. I'm going to give this here to the dead for a second. There you go, boom. And you can kind of follow the screen, and we'll just do it that way. And I'm going to sit right here.
Okay, so my name is Brett Haynes. I was raised in Yankton. Graduated high school in Yankton, did some college in Sioux Falls, Southeast Tech. I work at RBS Sanitation, and, well, for retirement, I'm just about to hit 20 years for the guard, but I'll probably stay in for the next couple of years.
Ooh.
My immediate family, here.
That's a good job.
We live kind of by the Davis exit, out in the country, so these little guys can roam and run and cause havoc. My walk with Christ, when I was growing up in Yankton, attended church, Calvary Baptist, baptized down in Calvary Baptist in Yankton. When I came to college, kind of became a little stagnant, and then once I got out of college, got back into it. And so with part of that, I think I have to get my notes.
Yeah.
So when asked about my favorite verse, it used to be Isaiah 6:8. I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Who shall I send and who will go for us?" Then I said, "Here I am, send me."
Yeah.
But as being asked that and giving this same story about three times this last week, I think I changed it to Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, mm-hmm. plans to give you hope and a future." Because the story was, as a kid, I told myself I was never going to be in the National Guard. I was going to go regular Army. So now 20 years later, and then when I was like 9, I saw the garbage man outside my house, and I go, "That job does not look like fun. I would never be a garbage man." And here I am 14 years into doing that.
Amen. Amen. Anything you want to say to the church?
Nope, that's it.
That's it. Perfect. She who has a broken leg. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Her ankle with her boot.
Hi. All right. Brett already introduced me. My name is Rachel.
You have to keep it closer.
My name is Rachel. And Brett has already introduced our children. So I think what I'm going to do, next week, both of my children go to school.
Mm.
And so I saw up on your screen something that just was perfect, that I'm going to be exploring my call from God, what God would like for me to do next. the next important part that we were given an email to prepare for this. And so the next important part, my husband reminds me that there may be a time limit.
So does the pastor.
We're supposed to talk about our walk with Jesus and our favorite Bible verse. This question has been brought up in Bible class as well.
Yep.
And I freeze every time. You guys, I've been working on this day, particularly joining your church. I've been thinking of it in my heart for months of what I'm going to say and how to prepare. So this may not come together well as I planned. I've been telling Brett for months that I'm not ready. Even today, as we drove, I told him I'm not ready. But I Googled, which gets me into trouble sometimes. I Googled what reaffirmation means. And I'm just going to read straight from Google. "Reaffirming your faith might not happen in a day or even a week. But what is essential is that you take an active role."
Mm-hmm.
my relationship with Jesus, it has holes. Whole areas that I need to give to him and to let go. I don't have a Bible verse. I'm working on it. I'm surrounding myself with people with the same goals that I have. Which brings me to you, to our church family.
Amen.
I wanted to bring up some important things that I think you need to know as a congregation. So over the last few years, what has brought us closer to you guys? We've received cards for birthdays, anniversaries. I broke my leg. And we've had meals, texts, calls, cards, people that have checked in with us. I think it was our first week, our first month coming here. I'm not going to read this out loud, but there was a piece of paper that was slipped to us, and it was just encouragement that we were in the right spot at the right time to keep coming. And I've hung on to it to remind us where we're supposed to be. I've been told in the snack line that you guys are praying for us. You guys have encouraged me by buying my soap. Chatting in the bathroom. You guys have encouraged us to bring our children. When we first joined, we were pretty little. And we made a lot of noise in the back. And Pastor just spoke louder. And we never had anybody turn around and give us a dirty look or ask us to leave or tell us that there's a room. We've been able to teach our children how to sit nicely in church. I have sent questions upon questions to Pastor, and in our little mailbox, there's been books and articles that appear that help me grow my faith. You guys have encouraged us to be involved. VBS, beef, booth, say that 5 times. recently, my eldest brother passed, and I feel like we're still pretty new in this church, and Brett and I don't come up here and share a whole lot. This is probably the reason why, is because I bring a whole book. But as we sat in Vermilion in the funeral home and I looked up, we had people from this church that attended, that came to support, that came to love on us, that came to be next to us as we went through that transition. Just as we were deciding to become members, we couldn't make every weekend work for one thing or another, Brett being in guards. And we had another church family that told us that they would wait and join with us at the same time. And that meant a lot to me.
Amen.
I'm getting there. That's the end. So I saw a fun little thing on Facebook that it talks about we will never change the world or an individual by going to church. We will only change by being the church. So thank you. Thank you for coming alongside of us and encouraging us and preparing us.
Amen. Get up. You guys gonna help your mother? Ooh, yeah. Thank you. Awesome. Let's have the sixfold. We're going alphabetical, the Jones family. Whew. Thank you, thank you. So Vanessa's the lady who put up her hand. She was the one that brought the ponies last year when we had our kickoff, but she raised her hand that says, I have a candy cotton machine. Oh, I'm so glad. Oh. We're going to start with the oldest to the youngest. How is that? I'm going to even let you hold it. This is amazing. You have grown probably the most in terms of shooting up since I started here 6 years ago. I think I used to pat you on the head. Now I might have to pat you on your belly button. Anyway, tell us who you are and where you go to school and what grade.
I'm Benson Jones, and I go to school in Parker, and I'm going to be a freshman this year.
And what did you spend a lot of time doing this summer?
Baseball.
And was it a good summer?
It was.
Excellent. Pass it on to your next sibling. And your name with two N's, tell us. No, it's not. Oh, it's the other one. Oh, I got it wrong. We have three Finleys now, and I've got to remember. Okay, Finley with one N. Tell us, where do you go to school?
Parker.
What grade?
Six.
What did you do this last summer?
A lot of 4-H.
A lot of 4-H, that's right. Let me think. What sport did you do when your mom was the coach?
Volleyball.
Ooh, and are you thinking of doing that again?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, good. What's the most favorite thing you like to do?
Ride a horse.
Ride a horse, good. And you have a few?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Yeah. Give it to this guy right here. Mr. Brooke, tell us what grade you're in.
Going into.
Second grade. And where do you go to school?
Parker.
Is your dad still the president of the school board?
No.
Oh.
Yes, he is.
So he's got lots of...
Oh, yes.
Oh, he is. Do you wish that he wasn't? No, we won't go there. Here we go. What do you like to do? You like to play soccer? You like
football.
To be inside? Football? Ooh, good job. All right. Oh, and who is this girl that I used to carry around? I still remember our first Operation Christmas Child. I had you in my arms. Oh, how old are you?
Five.
And are you going to school this fall?
No.
Yes, you are.
We've got a little family rift here. We don't want to have a school board president. We don't want to go to school. Oh, my. What's your favorite color?
Purple.
Purple? Oh, thank you. Oh, yeah, that's wonderful. And what's your favorite animal?
Horses.
Horses, good job. You want to give that to Mom?
Yeah.
Good. I'll let you do the list.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm Vanessa, and I was raised in Lemoore, North Dakota. And which is southeastern North Dakota. And then I went to high school through there, and then I went to USF in Sioux Falls, and then worked for a little bit, and then I went back to Southeast, and I am an ultrasound tech at Avera, PRN, and then I started dog grooming this last year from my home.
And what's the name of the company?
Nails to Tails.
Nails to Tails, oh yeah. Oh, good.
Yeah.
I just got a picture of this, you know.
And then, my immediate family. We live 5 miles north of here in the country, Chancellor. I grew up in a church like this in my hometown, small community, and have always been involved and Jesus in my heart. You want me to keep going? Life first. Hebrews run with perseverance.
Yeah, Hebrews 12, sure.
That's kind of mine. And, yeah.
Awesome. As you pass that mic, tell us the connection between where you live and that family named Fincher.
So my name is Ransom Jones, and we live 5 north here near Barry and Darla Olson. But we live on the Fincher farm, the original homestead of Frank Fincher. And you guys know Ed Fincher. So it was their original homestead, and we moved there in 2015. It's really been a blessing for us. We moved out of Sioux Falls, and just to be in that location, and we really had the warmth of the neighbors, and just the community. The community was tremendous. So we're on the Fincher farm. Yeah, and we love it. We're thankful to be there. I'm a nurse anesthetist. I do anesthesia. So I went to school at Georgia Southern University. I'm from Georgia, a small town in Lafayette, Georgia. North Georgia, just south of Chattanooga, Tennessee, is where I was born and raised. Went to school at Georgia Southern University for undergrad, and then went to Mount Marty for anesthesia, a nurse for many years in the emergency room, then became a flight nurse, and then became a nurse anesthetist. I work for Avera, and hope to retire someday. But as you can see, life can be expensive. Yeah. My immediate family, most of my immediate family are back in Georgia. But as far as immediate family, you're looking at how blessed we are and how blessed I am.
Amen.
Live in Chancellor. We talked about that already. My walk with Christ. I was from Georgia and went to grew up in a First Baptist church in Georgia. And was baptized when I was 12 years old, and I've always had a constant pursuit for the Lord and tried to stay as close as I could to Jesus in my heart and being mindful of that. And you can tell when that relationship becomes further away and when it's closer. And I can just tell you that my life's better when it's closer. I assume it's the same for most of you.
Amen.
So that's my walk, and we're certainly thankful to be here, grateful for this community. We've been going here since about 2018.
Yeah.
Went through the woes of COVID together with taped off pews and masks and all the things. And we've always, since day one, felt really welcome and comforted and loved by this church. So we're glad to be here. We went to a community-wide church before in Sioux Falls. We've always kind of come and gone through the church and been engaged in a church. But nothing that had deep roots and a sense of family like this church does. So we're really hoping to plant roots and be able to be a part of a community that's longer lasting, that we can grow with as a family. And that was this church. And one thing I want to say, and I get an opportunity to really get an opportunity to speak, but one thing I want to say is that, and I won't take a long time here, is that when the teachers stood up earlier, and I am on the school board, and I'm reluctant to announce that because I get a lot of phone calls that aren't super friendly. But I am on the school board at Parker. But when you saw those teachers stand up, I don't know that everyone understands the necessity that they provide in terms of teaching our young ones in the classroom. We have almost a crisis and shortage of teachers in our country. This year in Parker, we'll be using e-learning. We can't find a language arts English teacher to teach in Parker. And that's teaching your high schoolers English.
Hmm.
And we're not the only school. This isn't unique to Parker. There's another 150 schools that don't have an English teacher. So when those people stood up and said they're willing to teach our youth, it's a tremendous, tremendous thing. And we should certainly be thankful for them.
Amen.
So that's my school board plug. I'm thankful for the teachers. So thankful for you guys. Thankful for this church. Hebrews 12:1. Race with endurance or perseverance the path that's marked out for you. I don't know what race you're on. Maybe it's a financial race. Maybe it's a medical race. Maybe it's depression. Maybe it's anxiety. Maybe it's something that's really hard within your family. You're struggling to get along with your neighbor. I don't know what's going on in your life. We all have a race. But just know if you run it with Jesus, you can get there. You can stay with it. So thank you, guys.
Amen. You guys just sit in the front for a second so I can just hear the prayer. Thanks. Whew, one more. Here we go. Great to have. The next time, so Dwayne Smith is bringing the word next week, and all of the kids will be sharing from the Rocky Mountain High Trip. If ever I can't fill the pulpit again, then just ask Ransom. So we need to have that happen too. So, all right, you guys want to get on a step? I think this would be really good. Ooh, so you got to turn around. Who are you?
Millie.
Millie. And Millie, is what grade are you going into?
I'm going into second grade.
Second grade. And what school?
Lennox Elementary.
Oh, yes. What would your favorite color be?
Pink and purple.
So what you're wearing is really one of your favorites.
Yeah.
Oh, and you look very pretty in it. I will say that, too.
Thank you.
What kind of thing do you like to do?
Soccer.
Oh, soccer, yeah. And do you like reading or craft work or that kind of stuff, or just playing?
I I like reading.
You like reading too? Oh, good. Good job. And who are you?
Ella.
Ella. And how old is Ella? Ooh,
five.
Five. Oh, good. And are you going to kindergarten this year?
Yeah.
Yeah. And what kinds of things do you like to do?
Soccer.
Soccer too? Oh. And I have driven by your house before, and I've seen you guys on bicycles. Yeah, that's kind of a cool. Yeah. Oh, you want to say something? Yes.
We have a sandbox. And
you have a sandbox?
And sometimes you go to the pool on hot days.
Oh, I like that swimming pool in Lenox. Isn't that kind of cool?
Oh, I have a favorite verse.
Oh, you have a favorite? Oh, stand beside me. It's
you
a little hard.
Tell me whatever. It.
Oh, sure.
It's Isaiah 45:5a. I am the Lord, and there is no other. Besides me, there is no God.
I think that's wonderful. Amen. And what's your name?
Lana.
Oh, yeah. Good job. Good. Dad, maybe we'll start you. However you want to start that work.
Let's okay. go together. Yeah. Yes, this is Lana. She's very good. So my name is Robert Weidner. I was raised in Winter, South Dakota. For schooling, I went to Winter High School. I also went to Waldorf University in Iowa. Got a degree in Homeland Security. As far as my job, is not in Homeland Security. I actually work over at Sioux Steel in Lenox. Is retirement someday. That'd be nice. My immediate family, I do have my folks are still with me. They're still with the family. They're in Winter. My grandmother is also still alive. She's actually a Good Samaritan in Sioux Falls. We live in Lenox, right in Lenox. We still haven't seen when Pastor Mark drives by, but he likes to let us know that he sees us out there. my walk with Christ was actually with my grandmother, the one that I mentioned. Her name is Jackie Stone. When I was very, very young, and I'm going to say maybe about 8 or 9, she just said, you know, nobody wants to go to church with me. Do you want to go to church with me? And I said, sure. And I went with church with Grandma every Sunday. One of our favorite jokes was we would tell Grandpa that we had lunch if we had communion. but it was a wonderful, wonderful church. It was the United Methodist Church. My favorite book of the Bible, which I was surprised that Jones has said, but Hebrews. Hebrews 11 is probably my favorite. 1 in 6, specifically dealing with faith. I think that's so important. And a word from me to you guys. Just thank you. Thank you for being here for my family. Rachel, especially for helping out with baby Lana. She can be quite a handful. And her favorite thing of coming is to spend time with Rachel. So... which is great. And then also, so you guys know, Brett and I are actually going to be scout leaders. So if anybody needs anything from the scouts, please let me know. We're always looking for community service projects. So if you have something, please let me know. All right, thanks.
So my name is Brianne Weidner. I was raised in Rapid City, South Dakota. That's where I went to high school, and then I went to college at Black Hills State University, and I got a degree in mass communications with an emphasis in photography, so I like to do portraits and photography. Currently, I am running a cleaning company, which keeps me very, very busy. My immediate family is up here. I have a father and two brothers in Rapid City. We live in Lenox, and my walk with Christ, I've always known the Lord. I've become better at going to church recently. I had a friend, her name was Luetta, and we talked about Christ and the Lord a lot, and she really encouraged me to go to church, and she said, I know that you have faith, I know that you know the Lord, but it's very important to go worship on Sundays. And she said, you know, think about those little girls, they need to know the Lord. And she helped introduce me to this family, and once we started going, we just fell in love and haven't stopped, don't plan to. So my favorite book of the Bible is 1 Corinthians. I went to First Christian Church growing up, and for some reason when I was little, I thought it was First Corinthians. So I became very familiar with the book of Corinthians, and I just appreciate the message of you know, being able to put things aside, come together, worship together as a family. Amen. So,
wow, let's thank them too. Why don't you all come up? Come on up. We'll do that. Stay up here. That'd be good. Ooh, here we go. Oh yes. Old babies and everybody else. Let me give this to you for a second. Sorry, I'll do that too. Oops. Give that to you, Dad. Give that to Mom for a second there. Perfect. All right, family, we get to pray over them. Let's have the praise team work their way up too. Let's just do that so we can move in together. Wow. Here they are, folks, part of the family. So I'm going to ask you, as family members, are your arms open wide? Are your hearts ready to be delighted by how it is that God has created them uniquely, how they'll do ministry in our midst, and we get to do that together with them? Are you open and willing to receive the spiritual gifts that they have, and how it is that they'll help us walk together to love God more and to love people, make disciples? So, if you're ready to receive them, say, bless you out loud, and they'll hear it.
Bless you.
Awesome. Let's pray. God, we give you thanks again for the joy of the Haineses and the Joneses and the Weideners. We give you thanks for how it is that they have been a blessing to us, and we've heard that we get to do it mutually. It's a joint thing, walking together on this road of faith. So grant us grace, help us to continue to encourage and love up on one another, and in all things may it be that you would receive the praise and the glory now and forever. Amen. Let's clap one more time for them. All right, you can go back to wherever you want. We'll sing. Awesome. Thank you. What a joy. So thanks again for joining. If you have questions or if you would like to explore what membership is here, we certainly would love to hear from you. Chat with me over coffee even afterwards. So the praise team is here. We're in this thing together. 1, 2, 3, right? Let's go. So would you stand and worship with us? Not only do you get to love wherever you go, but we get to sing in praise. We started with praise, we'll end with praise.
All my life, all I know, God's been good, good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. All my life, all I know, God's been good, good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. God is for me, He's not against me. I will hold to the plans He has for me. When I'm broken, He will fix me. I will call on the name of the Lord. All my life, all I know, God's been good, good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. He's my heart song in my sorrow. He's my hope and my strength for tomorrow. When the storms rise all around me, I will call. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. I got joy, joy, joy deep in my soul. And I will sing, sing wherever I go. All my life, all I know, God's been good, good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. All my life, all I know, God's been good, good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go.
Boy, you almost want to say hee-haw as opposed to amen, huh? All right, if you're one of those three families, if you'd head out first, we want to honor you. Get a donut for Lana. She needs one. And thanks to the Burns family for doing that. But head on out. Go. I'll follow up on all that stuff. Don't worry. And as they go, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be yours in great abundance. Thanks for being an awesome congregation. We love you, and keep loving each other. Amen and amen. Go in peace.